This is Mumbai, one of India's largest cities and her financial capital. A city rushing headlong into an unknown future with all its problems of pollution and shortages of basic needs. 15 million people crammed in at a density of 21,000 people per square kilometer. To keep the city going, citizens are supplied with water and electricity with what amounts to subsidy. And that is in addition to the money spent on public servants and public works infrastructure without which this city will never survive. And this is Gavatka, a tiny tribal village on India's Western Ghats in Thane district. People have lived here for centuries and nature provides them with everything they want. Recently, the state government has planned to build a series of drinking water reservoirs for Mumbai, which will submerge this village and others like it forever. In return, they'll be given money for their lands, which these people neither need nor want. This will result in their lands being taken from them forcibly. It is like someone wanting to occupy your home without your consent, so that they can live a life of luxury and boredom. This is the Lendi River, part of the Quixotic Damanganga-Pinzar River Linking Project, on which a dam has been proposed where she meets the Wagh River. The dams have been planned against all logic. It is estimated that almost 60% of Mumbai's water needs can be provided for if rainwater harvesting is implemented. A further 25% of the 2 billion liters supplied daily can be saved if theft and wastage is averted. But there is no political will to enforce these measures because people have got used to cheap subsidized water. The easier way is to build dams in faraway lands owned by the poor. While they lose their lands, contractors and their political masters make money. No one is even talking about loss of forests and biodiversity. This is the footstep of Bhiva, a revered mythological hero for the locals. To an outsider, these are just some stones and rubble, but to the Adivasi or tribal, it represents the setting for the stories passed on by word of mouth by their ancestors, of floods and famine, of celebrations, of times gone by. The valley therefore is sacred to them. In time to come, it will be completely submerged and Bhiva will be forgotten. So what is the future for this village? This is what the villagers have to say. The dams will submerge a simple tribal way of life which has sustained an environmentally friendly culture for thousands of years. Their cultural traditions tied to their way of life will also probably not survive and pass into the darkness of history. The question is, what do the people of Mumbai think about this?